traveling left them ready for some playtime.
Yeah, me too. And now I want to try out the skateboard.
Cool! I'll try one too. Let's see how fast they can go.
Blah, blah.
Okay, you ready?
You're on.
Hey, Max, can you catch up to me?
Whoa!
Max, are you okay?
What's the big idea? You tripped me up.
What? Max, I stopped, but my skateboard kept going. If anyone should be sorry, it's you. You cut me off.
Nah, you did it on purpose.
The skateboard just kept going on its own.
Prove it.
I'm calling Siara. I bet she can tell you how something like this can happen.
Fine.
Hey, May and Max. What are you two up to?
We were playing out in the field with May's Pokémon, and we decided to try some skateboards. But then May tripped me up with her skateboard.
Hey, I did not. You cut me off, and I had to stop short. But my skateboard kept going.
That's ridiculous. A skateboard can't move by itself.
Well, actually...
Ha! Told ya!
Why don't we explore the way things move, and then you can figure it out with the facts.
Okay.
Now, when things move, they're in motion. Think about all that you see moving each day. What moves because something moves them?
That could be almost anything, like skateboards, surfboards, balls, and bats.
Right, and when they move, they have one thing in common.
What's that?
Pushes and pulls make them move.
Like when I push the skateboard with my foot.
Yeah, or like when you push a pencil across a table or pull a book out of a book bag.
Or push a friend on a swing.
You got it. These pushes and pulls are called forces. You can throw things or grab them, blow on them, or pick them up.
What about when we move?
You're using forces then, too. Like when you pull yourself out of bed in the morning.
Sometimes I'm so tired. I need to use a lot of force.
So anytime you move, you're using force?
You got it.
But what kind of force made my skateboard keep moving after I stopped?
Well, first, what force made your skateboard move while you were racing?
Me! I was pushing it. But then afterwards, it just kept going. So maybe it was the wind?
It could partially be the wind. The wind is a force, too. It pushes against things and makes them move, like with sailboats. But things in motion don't stay in the same place. They change position. So where you're standing right now...
Okay.
That's your position. But if you take a step forward...
My position changes.
You got it.
But some things move fast and some move slowly, right?
Right. How fast something moves, or its speed in a particular direction, is called velocity. Things that are in motion can change their velocity. They can speed up or slow down.
Okay, but can't you push on something to make it move faster? Like pushing hard on a skateboard.
Sure. Or you can pull on something to slow it down.
So you can use force to change speed?
You got it. Forces can change velocity. Things can also move to the left or to the right. They can move up or down.
Back up or turn around?
Or zigzag?
Those are all ways things change direction.
Can you use force to change direction, too?
Yes.
And that's what May did with her skateboard. She skated it into me.
Well, don't jump to conclusions just yet. Think about a baseball game. A pitcher throws a ball to home plate. When a batter hits it, the ball changes direction. It heads out into the field.
How does that prove May didn't make the skateboard ram into me?
Well, hang on. What would happen if you caught a ball?
It would stop moving?
Exactly. Things in motion will keep moving until something stops them.
Like the way my skateboard kept going on its own, even though I hopped off.
Yep. They'll keep going until another force makes them stop. That's their momentum.
Ha! See, momentum and force and position did it.
Fine, but you still didn't win.
Not yet.
Is that a challenge?
Why don't you guys get ready for a rematch and take a closer look at motion in action?
Let's do it.
As you watch the game, answer the questions for what will happen next. What did May use to get the ball in motion? That's right. May used the force of throwing the ball to get it moving. What can Max do to keep the ball in motion? That's right. Max used the force of hitting the ball to keep it moving.
What happened to the ball? Did it change?
That's right. The ball changed direction.
What happened to the ball? Did the ball's direction, motion, or momentum change?
That's right. The ball changed momentum. All right. Nice going.
Thanks for your help, Siara. I think we've got this figured out now.
No problem.
See you later.
Bye.
Help Squirtle get through this maze with what you know about motion.
Sounds like Squirtle will need to move up and down, back and forth.
Not to mention back up and turn around.
Ready? Let's go.
Things in motion can speed up or slow down. They can change. Awesome! Things in motion will keep moving until something stops them because they have... Right! Things in motion can change which way they move, or they're... Great! When things move, they don't stay in the same place. They change. Awesome! Okay, Max, I think it's time you and I get back in motion. You know, I really didn't mean for you to get tripped earlier.
I know. It's okay. I now know enough to watch out for objects in motion. Whoa! Not again! Thanks, May. I think I've had all the motion I can handle today.
Try again. Remember, we use pushes and pulls to get things moving. Remember, we use pushes and pulls to get things moving. What would give the ball the force it needs to fly? Try again. What would give the ball the force it needs to fly? Remember, things can change which way they move. Try again. Remember, things in motion will keep going until something stops them. Try again.
Try again.